In this lesson, we'll be shading our clouds, and then you'll learn to use layer masks to give the clouds a partially erased effect. We can now toggle the checkbox next to our clouds layer to show the visibility again. And now to add texture and visual interest to these clouds, we're going to start by shading just as we did with the other ones. So this layer is still set to alpha lock. Tapping the brush tool, we're going to grab this light blue color, zooming in on these a bit, and then increasing my brush size to about 25. I'm going to dust in some darker color on the bottom edge of all of these clouds. And then grabbing this light pink, adding a bit of this pink to the upper right side. And now this is much more subtle than the mountains because we are going to make these slightly transparent and simultaneously learn about layer masks. Similar to alpha lock, layer masks are a way to really have fine-tuned control over what you are painting and the area that it is painted in. Dissimilar to alpha lock, however, masks are a non-destructive way of painting, so I highly recommend this if you foresee having lots of changes or adjustments. If you're working on something for a client and you need to be able to provide tweaks and changes, masks are one of many tools that you can use to ensure that your artwork isn't all flattened on a single layer and that you're able to really refine those adjustments that you might make. So tapping on my cloud layer to access the side menu, right below alpha lock, I'm going to tap the mask option, and this creates an attached mask layer above this layer. If I were to move my layer 5 around, the mask will always move with it. And you can see one of these, the layer mask is the brighter blue and the cloud layer is the darker blue. That means that I'm selected on the layer mask. You can still draw on your layer normally by selecting that. What a mask does is it allows you to make changes to whatever is painted on the layer that you can at any time toggle the visibility on and off. This is going to function as a erase tool for us. So what we're going to do is use the eraser tool on our mask layer. So making sure that I have the mask set to this bright blue, meaning that I have it selected. I'm gonna grab my eraser tool and set this to the spray paint fine nozzle brush. I'm gonna increase my opacity to 100%. So we'll be relying mostly on the pressure of the pencil to determine the amount that we erase. I'm gonna decrease the size a bit though to about 15%. And now when I start to erase on this layer, because it's a texture brush and I'm using such light pressure, I'm able to remove just some of this layer. And what I'm trying to do is keep mostly the border and then fade it into being more transparent in the middle. I like doing this for clouds because I think it makes them feel more wispy and more like what they are, just vapor in air. And now what's really cool about masks is if you feel like you took too much away, like here, I've just erased a solid portion of my cloud. If I switch to my brush tool and I set this to a pure white, now when I go to paint back, it'll put back everything I erased without adding more pigment to the layer. And so you can see my color variation stays the same. Everything else is just as it was. So then I can go back and use my eraser. Alternatively, you can use the paintbrush and set your color to black or various values of gray and that'll give you various values of erasing. But I like to use just the eraser tool because I find it more straightforward and easier to keep track of what I'm doing. To recap, in this lesson, you've learned to use layer masks to hide part of a layer in a non-destructive way, and finished up the clouds portion of this piece. In the next section, you'll learn some more advanced layer techniques as we begin to create a reflection in the lagoon.